Hello and welcome. This is Chandni Nebnani and you are watching It's Tomorrow News. Earthquake in Albania kills 23, injures many. At least 23 people have been killed, several more are missing and hundreds have been injured after an earthquake struck Albania on Tuesday. The quake, which had a preliminary rating of 6.4 magnitude, hit the European nation at an approximate depth of 20 kilometers early on Tuesday local time, according to the United States Geological Survey. It is the strongest to hit Albania in 40 years. The epicenter was in the port city of Injures, about 36 kilometers, that is 22 miles from the capital Tirana. Social media videos from the area show several buildings have collapsed. Albanian Prime Minister's office revised the death toll upwards several times on Tuesday. At least four victims died in Injures, officials said. Another two died in Tumane. One person died after jumping from a building in panic in Kurbin, and one victim died while driving on a badly damaged road in Leze, the spokesperson added. 45 people have been pulled alive from the rubble and 600 people have been given medical assistance. Neighboring countries, the European Union and the United States have all offered immediate support. But experts were warning the worst was unlikely to be over for the Balkan country. Schools in the country have been closed for the day and flights from Tirana's airport suspended because of damage to the buildings. The early reports of fatalities included two women who were found in the rubble at an apartment building in Tuman and a man who died in the town of Kurbin after jumping out of a building. Three people died in the western port city of Injures, 20 miles from Tirana, including two whose bodies were taken out of a collapsed building. Emergency workers told local media one of those killed in Injures was an elderly woman who had managed to save her grandson by shielding him with her body. Tirana's municipal authorities had rushed to set up shelters for the thousands who had gathered in the streets of the capital. Unverified video footage posted on social media showed what appeared to be a collapsed building in Injures. Other footage showed buildings with large cracks and fallen masonry, including one apartment with most of a bedroom wall missing. A series of aftershocks were felt throughout the region on Tuesday morning. In nearby Bosnia, another quake with a preliminary magnitude of 5.4 struck southeast of the capital and rattled Sarajevo. These were no immediate reports of casualties or damage. The quake was felt as far afield as southern Italy and northern Greece, though Greece's leading seismologist Eftimios Lekas said it had not impacted or activated its own seismic fault lines. Countries across the region offered assistance and support, with Kosovo, Montenegro and Serbia all pledging to send assistance and rescue teams. Greece said it would immediately deploy disaster response teams to the neighboring country. Albania and the wider Western Balkan region experiences regular seismic activity. A 5.6 earthquake shook the country on 21st of September, damaging about 500 houses but causing no fatalities. In 1963, a powerful quake struck Skopje, the capital of nearby North Macedonia, destroying most of the city and killing more than 1,000 people. The Albanian government declared Wednesday a national day of mourning for the victims. Neighboring Kosovo, which has a large Albanian population, will also recognize Wednesday as a mourning day. Rescue crews in Albania use excavators to search collapsed buildings for survivors. Local television broadcast footage of rescuers pulling a young boy from a collapsed building after an excavator moved a broken slab of concrete and people pulled mangled reinforcement bars out of the way. It was not immediately clear how many people were still under the rubble. The rescue teams have to work slowly because there is a high risk of further collapse, endangering not only residents but also those trapped and the rescuers themselves. The EU said it had activated its civil protection mechanism at the request of the Albanian authorities. While Albania is not an EU member, the mechanism allows Brussels to respond to emergencies outside EU borders. The bloc engaged its Copernicus satellite monitoring system to deliver images of the area and mobilize three search and rescue teams, according to EU Humanitarian Commissioner. About 400 Albanian soldiers were erecting tents in two towns to shelter people with damaged houses. Tuesday's quake was the second to hit the country in 2 months and was felt along the Adriatic coast. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Chandni Nebnani. For more weather updates, do like, share and subscribe our channel.